Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss about niacin. Niacin is one of the vitamin belonging to B complex family. It is considered as vitamin B3, which is also called as nicotinic acid. So simply, niacin is a pyridine 3 carboxylic acid. This nicotinic acid can also act as anti-hyperlipidemic agent, as niacin is going to reduce the total cholesterol levels. And it can also impact one of the pathological cholesterol, LDL cholesterol. So niacin reduces the bad cholesterol. At the same time, this drug is going to increase the HDL cholesterol, which is considered as good cholesterol. It can also reduce the triglyceride levels. Thereby, it can reduce the VLDL levels. By all of these actions, niacin can act as anti-hyperlipidemic agent. It can be given either alone or in combination with other drugs in order to reduce the risk of atherosclerosis. So niacin can be used as a drug in the treatment of dyslipidemia, particularly type 2A dyslipidemia, which is associated with elevated levels of LDL cholesterol, and type 2B dyslipidemia, which is associated with elevated levels of both LDL cholesterol as well as VLDL cholesterol. Since this drug can reduce both LDL as well as triglyceride levels, it can be used in the treatment of type 2B dyslipidemia. And this drug can also reduce the risk of myocardial infarction, stroke. So this drug can be combined with other anti-hyperlipidemics such as statins in order to reduce the risk of atherosclerosis. So today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. Niacin is having a good absorption. Around 60 to 80% of the drug can be absorbed easily. But in order to increase the absorption, this niacin should be administered along with a low-fat snacks or meals, which increase the absorption, thereby increase the bioavailability of this drug. So with low-fat snacks or meals, niacin should be administered in order to produce effective response. Now let us see how this drug acts. This is the adipose tissue. Within the adipose tissue, cyclic AMP plays an important role. It can control the metabolism of triglycerides. These triglycerides can be converted into free fatty acids in presence of cyclic AMP. So triglycerides are converted to free fatty acids along with the release of glycerol. Here, free fatty acids are more important because they are going to be taken by the liver. Now, free fatty acids are going to be transported into the liver, where they are going to be stored into the VLDL. Now, liver can release the VLDL into the bloodstream, and now this VLDL can be converted into LDL. In this way, by increased lipolysis within the adipose tissue, results in the increased production of VLDL and LDL. But this lipolysis can be controlled by one of the receptors present on the adipose tissue, HM74A. This is a G protein coupled receptor associated with alpha, beta, gamma subunits. Now, niacin can bind to this receptor. By binding to this receptor, it produces an inhibition of adenylyl cyclase system. When this adenylyl cyclase is going to be inhibited, the ATP is somewhat less converted into cyclic AMP. So, this results in the decreased cyclic AMP levels, which reduce the lipolysis. Thereby, it reduces the uptake of free fatty acids into the liver, which results in the decreased production of VLDL and conversion into LDL. In this way, niacin can reduce the lipolysis within the adipose tissue, which reduces the production of VLDL as well as LDL into the bloodstream. So this results in the overall reduction in the total cholesterol levels, which reduce the risk of atherosclerosis. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of niacin is that this drug can increase the levels of uric acid. So uric acid levels are excessively increased in presence of niacin, which may increase the risk of precipitation of gout. So this drug should be carefully given in those patients who are having more risk for production of gout or in the patients with elevated uric acid levels. Similarly, when this niacin is combined with statins, it can increase the risk of rhabdomyolysis, the dissolution of the muscle fibers, which is mainly produced by statins. And this side effect is further enhanced by niacin. And any symptoms such as muscle weakness, fatigue should be thoroughly checked in order to avoid development of rhabdomyolysis. Similarly, niacin can increase the liver dysfunction Particularly, this is more observed when this drug is combined with statins, because statins can also increase the liver dysfunction. So, in the patients with any symptoms of jaundice or peptic ulcers, this drug should be carefully given because these conditions further increase the liver dysfunction. What are the side effects? The important side effect of this drug is the headache. Since this acts as a vasodilator, by increase the prostaglandin release, it can increase the headache, and it can also produce flushing, resulting in the redness of the face, some itching sensation, and pruritic conditions can be produced by this drug. In order to avoid this flushing, extended release tablets are used, and it can also be controlled by administration of aspirin 325 mg before 30 minutes, which reduces the flushing produced by niacin. Other side effects mainly include dizziness, tachycardia, which is because of reflex action, some chills, excessive sweating, and peripheral edema can be observed with this drug. How it is given? This drug is given as extended release tablet. Even normal tablets are available, but extended release tablets are having less flushing, improving the patient compliance. Initially, this drug is given at a dose of 500 mg. The dose is going to be maintained up to 4 weeks, and after 4 weeks, additional dose can be combined such that the dose may be slowly escalated for every 4 weeks, and the maximum dose of this drug is around 2000 mg. So that's about this drug niacin, which is a vitamin belonging to the B complex family, and it is also considered as vitamin B3 or nicotinic acid. This nicotinic acid can also act as anti-hyperlipidemic agent, as it reduces the LDL cholesterol, increases the HDL cholesterol, and it also reduces the VLDL and triglycerides. By all of these, it can reduce the total cholesterol within the body. So this drug can be combined with other drugs such as statins in the treatment of dyslipidemia, which is associated with elevated levels of LDL as well as VLDL. But when it is combined with the statins, the development of rhabdomyolysis or liver dysfunction should be thoroughly checked, and this drug can produce some flushing and headache, which can be controlled by administration of aspirin 325 mg before 30 minutes. So that's about this drug niacin. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.